with special guests, the Ricketts family, Theo and Steve, Chad Hoyer, Joe Manon, Rick Sutcliffe, Ryan Saber, Javi Baez,
Wells. There's going to be a dunk tank and everything. It's going to be a lot of fun. Speaking of the White Sox, a lot of like interesting things happening, right? They're kind of excited. Like, are they going to get Bryce Harper? Could they get Manny Machado?
Nobody. They suck over here.
Will the stadium links driving range be a permanent thing at City Rate Guaranteed Rate Field? Wouldn't that be something? Yeah, he got it. Getting golf balls into a major league stadium. You want to put people in the seats?
Nope.
If you allow them to hit, like, off of a driving mat into the field.
That's awesome.
Right? Wouldn't that be fun? Yeah. Like, if a player caught a fly ball and a titleist at the same time, it's three outs. Perfect. It's like, triple play, great play, out of the way. You're bringing on in, guys. Oh, man. And you know what? And I know the season ended a lot sooner than we all wanted it to end, right?
Yeah.
It happens. I want a ring. I want another one.
Yeah, Milwaukee's
finally put mine away for a little bit. Stop wearing it because I'm hungry for another one. I want us to win another one.
Yeah.
Yes. That's what happens. When you don't take care of business and you don't handle your stuff, then you have to play one game elimination games, right? You have to play a winner takes all. That's what happens. When you got a chance to bury somebody and put somebody in the way and you don't do it, that's what happens. Just ask the Cleveland Indians. That's the kind of stuff that can go on. And we got to kind of give our round of applause and tip our hat to the Milwaukee Brewers. They won.
No!
Tough crowd tonight.
Yeah.
Holy cow. No, we do. And you know what? I read an article. The Milwaukee Brewer players said something really interesting. They said, we really owe it to the fans because the fans provided such energy for us to go out there and play every day and have the season we did.
Cut fans.
Coincidentally, people who visited Miller Park the most in 2018? Cubs fans! Pat yourself on the back. Enjoy that moment. What else? I mentioned Bryce Harper, Manny Machado, that whole thing going on, you know, every day. The Yankees, the Phillies, the White Sox. It's like, man, if I wanted to watch The Bachelor, I'd just throw it on ABC. Who's going to get the final rose? And then randomly, you know, the mystery team shows up.
Ryan Denver.
You know, just hops out of a limo. The Bachelorette from season 23, there to find love. You know, just, and why can we never find the mystery team? Who is the mystery team? I don't know. We've been to the moon.
Bobby.
You know, we've done stuff like that. We've invented the internet. We can't even use the very device that we invented to find out who the mystery team is. I don't get it. I don't understand it. But, yeah, well, you know, you never know, right? It's always the last place you look. My dad always said it to me.
Dexter's coming back.
A lot of fun stuff. Actually, speaking of Bryce Harper, do you guys follow Bryce Harper or Chris Bryant on Instagram? Anybody?
Yeah.
You do? Yeah. Did you guys see this picture? Morgan, can you throw that picture up that we have? Where's that at? See that?
Nelly.
That's Bryce Harper, Chris Bryant with their wives, and Nelly. And you can't see it, it's normally on the bottom, but there's a caption that says, which one of us actually likes St. Louis? I thought it was kind of cute. That's pretty nice right there. Hall of Famer Lee Smith is here today. The Hall of Fame. After 15 years, he was on the ballot for 15 years. He has taken off the ballot, the Veterans Committee.
About time.
Right? About time. Yeah. Thank you very much. This guy, you're going to be sitting next to me by the end of the show. Give him a microphone. But Lee Smith's so laid back, you know. He never gets mad about anything. He's so laid back that when they ask him, they're like, hey, Lee, you know, what do you think about getting taken off the ballot? He's like, I'm a closer, 15 out of 16, that's pretty damn good. And I am feeling kind of a little fired up or emotional or a little bit sentimental. It's going to be really awesome to see number 46, the right-hander for the Chicago Cubs, go into the Hall of Fame in Cooperstown.
Yeah.
That one feels good right here. For anybody who doesn't know, I wore number 46 too. Explain it to us, some people who maybe don't know that. They're here with some family, they dragged me here. Hey, listen, all kidding aside, I just want to say something, and I just want to say thank you. I want to say thank you to all of our guests, year after year, who wait around, who come on the show, who give up their time. They're honest, they're candid, they stick things in their mouth. I want to thank all the people behind the scenes that put this show on. I'm talking about Max, Big Jim, Becca, even Joe Rios. For some reason, I'm thanking him.
Thank you, Ryan.
You're welcome.
Who's Joe?
I want to thank Banner, Banner Collective. They do all of the video work, all the production. Thank you for this. It's been 5 years putting this on. It's been an absolute blast. I want to thank the band, the Hemispheres. Everybody, please. So much fun. We're growing together. We're learning each other, and they're absolutely fabulous. And most of all, I want to thank you guys.
Yeah!
Thank you, Ryan.
I want to thank the fans, because the truth is, without you guys in this room, there is no show tonight, there is no convention, and there is no Major League Baseball.
Yeah.
And that's the truth. I'm not blowing smoke. I listened to Harry Carey's Hall of Fame speech the other day, and he said it, and he said it so great. He said, the fans are the unsung heroes of this great game. And I couldn't agree with any more than what he said. So thank you guys very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we have an incredible show tonight. So much fun, so many great guests. We're going to be right back after this short video. Stay with us.
This past year, about how the team never got to pop champagne and celebrate. I got to admit, this was a bit confusing to me. I mean, the guys do celebrate after each win, and that's a lot of wins, 95 to be exact. Joe did hold a toast to recognize making the playoffs for the fourth straight year, and of course, there were the occasional corks being popped. At least that's how I remember it. They say each celebration is unique and special to each team, and in 2018 was no different. Cheers to doing it again in 2019, for the fifth straight year.
Yeah, Ryan!
Burn it! So good in your eyes! Wow! Can't see.
You guys got me? You're the man!